From candy cone poles outside your local barbershop to the hidden meaning behind Bluetooth's logo, today we look at symbols that don't mean what you think. Number 10. Ichthys. Seen on the back bumpers of automobiles across the United States is the simplistic symbol known as the ichthys. The character is symbolic of various fish-related Bible verses and a first-century Christian acrostic in Greek which reads, Jesus Christus Theou Weos Soter, which translates to Jesus Christ, Son of God, Savior. But the origin of the symbol actually predates the religion and traces its roots back to various other cultures across time. In pagan religions, the ichthys was utilized for praising various maternal deities like the ancient Syrian goddess Attar Goddess, the Greek mythical Aphrodite, and the Egyptian deities Osiris and Isis, spawning from the ancient Greek term Delphos, which was used both for the word fish as well as the word womb, connecting the two terms to the symbol's roots in femininity, life, and the sea. It even reflects birth and vitality in some cultures, which may explain its eventual conversion to the colloquially known Jesus fish. However, theologians believe the connection came about as a means for early Christians to blend in with the symbolism of other religions and avoid detection by persecuting Romans while still signaling their allegiance to other believers. Number 9. Peace sign. Developed as part of the British campaign for nuclear disarmament, the modern-day peace symbol is far from the secret evil calling card it's been accused of being in the past. The designer, an artist named Gerald Hultum, modeled the flag semaphore signals for the letters N and D for nuclear disarmament. The symbol was presented to the Direct Action Committee, a British pacifist organization, in 1958, and was immediately employed in a protest march to the Atomic Weapons Research Establishment within a matter of weeks. In its composite form for an inverted V and a straight vertical line, the symbol proved easy enough for the everyman to replicate, yet complex enough to mask multiple meaning. In addition to representing flag-signaled letters, the form of the peace sign also represented Hultum's state of mind during the production process. Having found the matter of combat and nuclear technology to be an especially dismal subject, he designed the symbol to represent himself in despair with arms outstretched and pointing downwards as if pleading for some shred of relief. The peace sign, with its British beginnings, would make its way across the Atlantic by the early 1960s, from which it grew to the national and global prominence by which it's known today. Number 8. Barber pole. With companies like Coca-Cola and Pepsi often employing the same patriotic color scheme, it may come as a surprise that the red, white, and blue stripes iconic of barbershop poles have little, if anything, to do with the USA. Long before the medical trade became widely available to the public, barbers served a semi-double duty as minor surgeons, performing operations such as pulling teeth and even amputating limbs. The most popular procedure among these old salon surgeons, though, was the act of bloodletting. This was a means of draining what people thought of as potentially excess blood that could contain diseases and the plague. This archaic practice became a popular offer from barbershops after the 12th century decree from Pope Alexander III, who banned monks, priests, and other clergy members from performing the act. As barbers took over, they would use white cloths to stop the bleeding before wrapping them around poles to hang and dry outside. As for the blue, some claim it derives from blue veins targeted in bloodletting, and others still debate that it arose in the United States as a means of showing national pride. Today, the barber's pole is employed somewhat strictly, with only licensed barbers allowed to display the symbol in many American states, despite their long-abolished medical practices. Number 7. Rabbit's foot. The significance of the long-eared critter in global cultures and religions goes back thousands of years. But the concept of using its foot as a talisman wasn't recorded until the late 1800s in the United States, arising from hoodoo superstition and the subsequent black magic trade in New Orleans. During this time period, the use of rabbit's feet made their way into the writings of Southern white writers, and the mythos of their use spread. But how did it attain this designation among the superstitious? Well, one author and professor of American studies, Bill Ellis, predicts the source to lie in the contradictory nature of lucky tokens. If the front and right side of things are thought to be lucky, then the back left leg of a rabbit would incidentally be the most unlucky. In addition, the rabbit is thought to be a trickster in the African cultures that inspired the superstition, making the act of seizing and procuring a rabbit's foot to be a significantly unlucky affair to attempt. However, by way of surviving such bad fortune, the fruits of your efforts are destined to be resultantly steeped in good luck. At least, that's what Ellis hypothesizes. Number 6. Mistletoe. Now indicative of the time for holiday cheer and joyous celebration, mistletoe has grown to recognition as a Christian tradition in which one person may show their affection for another with a ritualistic kiss. Seeing as how the parasitic plant wasn't a Bible-born tradition, the concept of smooching under the mistletoe seems to originate from Norse mythology. The story goes that Loki crafted an arrow from mistletoe and was able to use it to slay fellow deity Balder. Upon Balder's resurrection, his mother, Frigga, declared the mistletoe to henceforth be a symbol of love and peace, one by which all gods and humans should celebrate her son's return. The tradition carried on throughout Europe, and as of the 18th century, it was being practiced commonly each year in Britain among servants. To add to the speed by which it spread, one popular belief was that to refuse a kiss was to risk bad luck. Thus, it naturally made its way to the modern world at large and carries on today. Number 5. Okay sign. A happy substitute for the thumbs-up gesture, the frequently used connecting of the index finger and thumb is a classic way to say A-OK. Well before its contemporary uses, however, the symbol was a staple in ancient Greece as a symbol of love and affection due to the way the digits slightly resemble puckered lips. The gesture also appeared in the Roman Empire during the 1st century as it made its first appearance as a symbol of approval. It's also an influential hand symbol in Buddhist and Hindu cultures, as it's often seen as a sign of inner perfection, with focus being paid to the circle formed rather than the touching of the fingertips. The tradition of using this gesture flourished globally, carrying this meaning in one way or another with the sense of perfection applying as a means of verification rather than speaking to any type of completeness. However, in Italy, the pointing of the fingertip and thumb slightly transformed the gesture from one of response to an exclamation of approval, often preceded by what's commonly referred to as a chef's kiss. Number 4. In the details. There's a number of symbols that rock musicians and scary movies love to employ, many of which have garnered connection to the occult. But some of these images, figures, and signals base their origins in areas that may be a bit surprising. One such symbol is the Petrine cross, notable for its resemblance of an inverted crucifix. Rather than displaying an outright protest against the teachings of Christianity, though, the emblem originally was known as the Cross of St. Peter. According to historical texts, when the Apostle Peter was crucified, he requested to undergo the sentence upside down, finding himself unworthy to go out in a similar manner to Jesus Christ. Thus, followers of the religion would recognize the upside-down cross to represent humility, and evidence of such can be found in ancient churches today. Only recently has it been incorporated by mainstream Hollywood to represent anti-Christian beliefs thanks to horror films like Rosemary's Baby and The Exorcist. Number 3. The Caduceus. Medical and healthcare company logos across the United States almost uniformly employ the emblem of a pair of snakes coiled around a winged staff. Although elegant, the symbol is equal parts enigmatic with no obvious relation to medicine and vitality. It first started being used in this way more than a century ago with the U.S. Army Medical Corps, but one officer's blunder that went unchecked gave this symbol new meaning. In actuality, the symbol was most likely supposed to be the rod of Asclepius, the Greek deity of medicine and healing. However, his rod had no wings and only a single snake. The logo itself is the caduceus, the staff of Hermes, but this Greek god was traditionally aligned with the domains of trade and travel, as well as being the messenger of the gods, which is why elsewhere in the world outside of America, the caduceus is instead used to mark centers of commerce. Number 2. Bluetooth. Invented by a Dutch electrical engineer named Jaap Harzen, it should come as no surprise that Bluetooth technology draws its unique name from Danish history. Uniting the nations of Denmark, Norway, and Sweden, the Viking lord, King Harald Blattand, earned the nickname of Bluetooth due to his penchant for eating blueberries. Due to its somewhat related similarity in uniting devices, the term became a natural choice for the wireless technology. Designers took this tribute a step further, though, when they used the Danish runes for the letters H and B for King Harald Blattand and mixed them to form the strange logo we see on our phones and wireless devices today. Number 1. Power on. Following the classic computer binary code of ones and zeros, the power on symbol we all recognize from contemporary electronics draws on a mix of the two digits, with the number 1 signifying on and 0 signifying off among engineers since the 1940s, a simple marriage of the two made for a refined, minimalistic, compound representation. The resulting emblem can be found on computers, video game consoles, televisions, and more, with its meaning reaching nearly universal recognition.